where we feature a man who, from very humble and very difficult childhood, rose to become a respected name in the banking world. Here's the personal story of James Mwangi, the CEO of Equity Bank.
Born in Kangema, Murang'a County 55 years ago, Equity Group CEO James Mwangi speaks of humble beginnings.
We lost our father at a tender age, and we were left with our mother Grace to bring us up. We were seven in the family, and so providing for seven kids, for a lady who had not gone for formal education and no economic activities, it was challenging.
He has been described as the dream maker who steered Equity Bank from an insolvent business to becoming the region's most profitable bank.
Equity is a creation of innovation. And the first innovation was disruption of the banking industry by democratizing banking. Banking was for elite, and only 4% of the population had bank accounts. So it was an exclusive class that enjoyed banking services. But we disrupted that by making banking inclusive.
Dr. James Mwangi is credited with providing leadership that has seen Equity Bank transform from a struggling building society to become one of the largest and most successful inclusive banks in the world.
Asking ourselves, why were ordinary people not being able to access banking industry? And we realized the barriers were simple. There were things like minimum balance. It had been placed at a very high level compared to the average incomes of Kenyans. And so people were finding it difficult to maintain minimum balance. The second thing was the requirements of account opening. There were things about introductions, and you were being expected to be introduced by people who had the current accounts here to the whole village would have nobody with a current account. So easing that requirement and bureaucracies like passport photographs to take to the banking.
His efforts slowly but eventually brought about change to an enterprise that had been ranked very low in the financial sector.
Really what drives me is the fulfillment that when I was given a chance, I didn't spare any effort in doing what I needed to do to realize the objectives. And if you look particularly what has driven me from for Equity, is seeing lives being changed and transformed. Is seeing quality of life of our people improving because they're enabled to realize their dreams.
Mwangi reflects on how far the bank has grown since its expansion.
I've come to appreciate that it's good to be endowed, it's good to be, but leeches and all that, leave them here. But the only thing that can last and outlive you for many years is a name. And so hopefully a reward of a name is worthy the effort.
But it hasn't been easy, he says. He attributes the success of the bank to the fact that the team has overcome many challenges.
That investigative approach of banks, I think being imposed on the bank may not be the right thing. When you come to, you must give us documents for any transfer that comes to the bank and verify to us that you genuinely own that. I don't think banks are very well positioned to execute this. When you withdraw a million shillings, you must tell us who the million is being given to. You give us the ID and where they are located, physical address. I don't think that is the right way to enable people to do business.
Last year, Polycarp Igathe was named Equity Bank Kenya Managing Director, and Mwangi extols Igathe's leadership credentials, describing him as results-oriented and focused.
The greatest test of success in the corporate world is managing succession. Legacy is not what you do, it's what happens when you're not on the steering wheel. And I see the bank, the staff being more passionate and enthusiastic to support Polycarp. Polycarp having come from the FMG, private sector there, he understood their problems.
Dr. James Mwangi is celebrated the world over for his passion and commitment to the transformation of lives through socioeconomic empowerment.
We felt that the society had given us a license to succeed in business. And we felt we had a duty to give back to that society. And so we developed the concept of shared prosperity. So we take the best girl and the best boy in every region that we have a branch after their secondary education, bring them to the bank for what we call coaching and mentoring for a year, to develop in them early the instincts of leadership.
Looking to the future, James Mwangi is determined that the bank will act as a catalyst for social economic transformation of the continent.
Success is not measured with money. It is measured with goals, dreams, aspirations, and purpose fulfilled, lived. It's challenges overcome. That's what success is all about.